Good morning. I am Santosh Bharti. Today I am going to discuss about the multiplexing in digital communication. Multiplexing means basically the time division multiplexing oblique pulse amplitude modulated signal. Means how to use the multiplexing techniques to transmit a signal, to transmit the digital signal or to receive the digital signal. Basically the application of the multiplexing in the digital communication system. Right. Before starting, now TDM, PIM, time division multiplex, pulse amplitude modulation. Now I am going to discuss what is multiplexing. Multiplexing is a process. If we are talking in terms of the digital electronics, now multiplexers is a combinational circuit which convert many signal, many input to single output, or in simple word we can say this is the many to one mapping, or many signal to unify into the one signal. Right? Clear? But in digital communication basically use the digital multiplexing. What is the difference between the multiplexing, analog multiplexing and digital multiplexing? In digital multiplexing basically it is based on the bit by bit interleave procedure. Clear? Bit by bit interleave procedure means how to select the inputs. Basically the selection of input is depend upon the number of select line. Clear? For example, if you want to transmit 10 signal, then how many number of select line are needed? There are 4 select line are needed. 2 to the power 4, that is 16. Now you can transmit 16 signal. You can multiplex up to 16 signal if you are choosing 4 select line. If you are choosing 3 select line, you have to multiplex up to 8 signal. If you have chosen 2 select line, you have to multiplex up to 4 input signals. So depending upon your input signal, you have to choose the number of select line. The same concept is also using here in the digital communication. Right? So in digital communication, now I am going to draw the block diagram of the digital communication system. So in digital communication system, basically suppose we have this is the commutator. This is the commutator. Suppose this is the codec. This is codec 2, codec 1. Suppose we have n number of codec. Suppose this is the X1T signal with the frequency F1, X2T with the frequency F2, up to X half and T with the frequency Fn. Clear? These are the input signal. How many signals want to multiply? Suppose we want to multiply the n number of signals. And this continuous time signal, this signal is converted into the discrete form, digital form by the codec. Clear? Not codec. Codec is the PCM form. This is the only low pass filter. These are the low pass filter. This is again low pass filter. This is again low pass filter. So this is the continuous time signal. To specify now this signal is the low frequency signal, passing this continuous time signal to the low pass filter, now you will get the low frequency signal. I mean the modulating signal. Clear? How many signals? There are n signals. Clear? Then this is the commutator. Commutator are used commutator, then the time modulation communication channels. All substitute modulation process the communication channel. This block is the time demodulator. This is the time modulator, time demodulator, and then again commutator circuit. Low pass filter, you will get the X1T. Low pass filter, you will get X2T. Low pass filter. XMT. So this is the procedure. This is the transmitter commutator, and this is the receiving decommutator. This is the receiver commutator. And this is the transmitter. Commutator. Now this is the synchronized. Synchronized means we have to receive the proper signal. Are the receiving signal received properly? If the transmitting commutator is properly synchronized with the receiving commutator, yeah. What is the role of commutator? Commutator basically TDM-PIM. In TDM-PIM, total time is divided into the number of slots, number of time slots. For example, suppose F1, we have to calculate the maximum frequency is max of f1 f2 up to fn, yeah. Then calculate the subtending frequency. This is equal to 2 time of f1. For example, suppose the 1 kilohertz, 2 kilohertz up to 5 kilohertz. The maximum frequency is suppose the 5 kilohertz. Then we have to calculate the subtending frequency. Subtending frequency is how much? 2 times of 5, that is 10 kilohertz. 10 kilohertz. Then calculate the subtending interval. 1 by fs, that is 0.1 millisecond. 10 kilohertz, 1 by 10 kilohertz, that is 1 millisecond. This is subtending interval. Then how to divide the total time, this total time to this small number of time slots. For example, suppose how many signals are transmitted? For example, suppose n is 10. Suppose we have to multiplex the 10 number of signal, 10 input signal is used to be multiplexed. Then time slots are 0.1 millisecond upon 10. How much? 0.01. So we have to divide now this sampling interval into the 0.01 millisecond. Yeah? For example, suppose 0.01, 0.02, 0.03, 0.04, 0.05, 0.06, 0.07, 0.08, 0.09, 0.08. 0.01. Divide the number of time frame. At this time interval, now the first signal is coming here at time modulator, and at this time now every signal is used to be the multiplex at the time modulator. Here the parallelly there are n signal, and here you will go to only the single output. Single output signal, right? This is a single output signal. So this is the procedure how to convert the total time divided into the smaller time slot. This is the principle of the TDM, time division multiplexing. Its total time is divided into the smaller time slots, and each time slot is responsible to transmit the individual signals. Each time slot are responsible to multiplex the individual continuous time signals. So this is the procedure, right? And the PAM monitor, now the multiple signal is uniform, then communication channel are used to carry these multiplex signal. PAM demodulator, again reverse of the PAM modulator, and decommutator again doing the reverse process of the commutator. Clear? And finally at the destination you will receive the individual signal at the destination points. So this is the procedure of the TDM PAM signal. Then how to calculate the one revolution? Basically, in one revolution is all the signals are going to be multiplexed. Clear? Then how to calculate the different parameters? Different parameters are calculated and I am going to discuss about the one revolution. One revolution equals to one frame. One revolution means when commutator rotate one complete cycle, that is the one revolution. So this is the one frame, and this is equal to n pulses. N pulses means n pulses are transmitted in the one revolution, or one, this is known as the one frame. Clear? How to calculate the pulse to pulse spacing? For example, suppose this is the one pulse, second pulse, third pulse, fourth pulse up to n pulse. This is the pulse 1, 2, 3, 4 up to there are n pulses are used. Think as n pulse equals to 1 frame. This is the 1 frame. And pulse to pulse spacing. And from here to here, this is known as pulse to pulse spacing. How to calculate pulse to pulse spacing? Basically, this is the TS, 1 by TS. How many number of pulses? There are 10 number of pulses, n number of pulses. So this is the TS by n, known as the pulse to pulse spacing, or this is equal to 1 by fs into n. This is pulse to pulse spacing, right? The next parameter is where n is the number of pulses. The next parameter is period of one pulse. The period of one pulse, this is equal to on time plus off time. Period of one pulse means this is the on time plus off time. This is the on time and this is the off time. This is equal to on plus off, or this is equal to 1 by n into fs. So this is the pulse to pulse spacing. This is equal to period of one pulse. Yeah, number of pulse per second. How to compute the signaling period? Signaling rate, this is known as bit rate. This is known as number of pulse per second. Bit rate. This is also known as bit rate. This is also known as pulse rate. This is also known as bit rate. This is also known as signaling rate. How to calculate the signaling rate? The signaling rate is basically, this is equal to n into fs. Fs is the signaling rate of one pulses. How many pulses are used? There are n pulses are used. N into fs. This is the signaling rate of the n pulses. N input, number of inputs. This is also known as bit rate. Where we know that now this fs is always greater than or equal to n into 2 times fm. Where fs is greater than or equal to 2 times of fm. So this is the signaling rate. Right? Now transmission bandwidth. Transmission bandwidth or digital bandwidth, this is equal to half of the bit rate. Or this is equal to half of the signaling rate. This is equal to half and greater than half into n into fs, or this is greater than or equal to 1 by 2 into n into 2 time of fm. 2 to cancel out. So signaling rate is greater than or equal to n into fm, not fs. This is fm. So these are the important formulas used to calculate the different parameter, means pulse to pulse spacing, period of one pulse, signaling rate, bit rate, and the transmission bandwidth required to transmit the n number of input, or n number of input is to be multiplexed. So these are the important parameter, important formulas are used to basically calculate the different parameter for the time division multiplex pulse amplitude modulated signal. Similarly, I am going to make condensed bias simple examples. In the examples, suppose there are 6 message signals. There are 6 message signal of bandwidth. A bandwidth of each message signal is the 5 kHz. Using the TDM, PAM modulation techniques and transmitted. We have to calculate. How to calculate? For example, we assume the simple example. Suppose we have to multiplex 6 message signal, and each of the bandwidth is the 5 kHz. Yeah? By using the TDM PAM modulation scheme and transmitted this signal. We have to calculate. How to calculate? Basically, signaling rate and channel bandwidth. We have to calculate signaling rate and channel bandwidth. How to calculate signaling rate? We know that how many channel? N is given, n equals to 6. And fm is given 5 kHz. Then signaling rate is either you can use this formula or this formula. This is equal to n into fs R greater than R equals to 6 and 6, Fm is 5 kilowatt, Fs is 2 times, so 2 into 5. How much? Greater than R equals to 60 kilowatt. The signaling rate is just 60 kilowatt. This is the first. Similarly, you have to calculate the channel bandwidth. Channel bandwidth are minimum channel bandwidth. So minimum channel bandwidth equals to transmission bandwidth. This is half of the signaling rate. Ready? Kilohertz of the bandwidth is required to transmit the 6 message signal, each contain the 5 kilohertz of the bandwidth using the TDM TAM signal. These all are related to the time division multiplexing pulse amplitude modulation. Similarly, now I am going to discuss about the TDM PCM signal. Basic concept is same in the TDM PCM signal. TDM PCM. Concept, basic concept is same, but the block diagram is different. So I am going to draw the block diagram of the TDM. Block diagram of the TDM PCM signal. TDM PCM signal, we have to use the multiplexer. This is the coding. Coding 1, here the PCM data. Coding 2, again give the PCM data, similarly. Codec M. This is input 1, input 2, up to input N. Multiplexer, basically this is the digital multiplexer. Now before that, TDM PAM is using the analog multiplexer, analog multiplexing technique, while in TDM PCM is the digital multiplexing techniques. Right? So this is the multiplexer. Now the light waveform generator. Light waveform generator at the here, you will get the multiplex PCM data. Multiplex PCM data, and here the light waveform generator. Now this signal is passing through the low pass filter. Low pass filter, then again here. Low pass filter, then pulse regenerator. Pulse regenerator at the output. We will get the PCM data. PCM data, then making the demultiplexer. Demultiplexer and again codec, codec 1, codec 2 up to codec N, and finally at the destination we will receive the signal 1, signal 2 up to signal N. So this is the, this portion is basically known as the transmitter part, this is the receiver part, and this is the channel. regenerative repeater. This part from here to here is the transmitter, here to here is the receiver, and this part is known as the channel. This is the channel. Clear? If you are transmitting now your signal from the long distance, then you need to the regenerative repeater. What is the role of regenerative repeater? Now it receives the corrected data, distorted data, re-clean, re-amplify, and retransmit for the further distance. But if you are doing for the short distance communication, there is no need of the regenerative repeater. Yeah? So basically, this is the coder decoder. Coder, it converts the continuous time signal into discrete form, digital form. Digital form, digital data. This is the digital, PCM is the digital data. Digital data 1, digital data 2, up to digital data. Are input and now these digital signal are multiplexed by using the digital multiplexers. Here you will get the multiplexed PCM data. Now this signal is passing through the line waveform generator. Now this digital data is converted into the waveform, binary waveform, PCM waveform data here. Clear? Now this signal is transmitted through the channel. If it is a long distance transmission, needed the regenerative repeater. If it is a short distance, no need of the regenerative repeater. Then at the receiver, passing this signal to low pass signal, the pulse regenerator, again pulse regenerator are used to convert the digital waveform, binary waveform, into the binary data, that is known as PCM data. And again using the multiplexing technique to separate out the individual input, and it is finally go to the individual destination point. So this is the complete procedure of the TDM PCM signals. Clear? This is the complete procedure of the TDM PCM signal. Then we have to calculate the frame format. Frame format. Now I'm going to discuss about the frame format. So this TDM PCM signal is also known as the T1 carrier system. This TDM PCM is also known as the T1 carrier system. So frame format. How to calculate the frame format of T1 carrier system? The frame format of the T1 carrier system is basically how many, suppose we have to transmit the n number of input signal, and every input signal basically denoted the frame. Yeah? Now this denoted by 193 bit. How basically this is 24 channel plus 1 sync bit. Well, so now I'm going to discuss about the how many channels are. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 bit are used for the channel 1. This is channel 1. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 This is the channel 2. Similarly, we have the channel 24. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 8. This is the channel 24 and one sync bit. So this is the frame forward of the Tiber carrier system. This is again 193 bit. So these are the time frame. So one frame equals to 24 channels plus one sync bit. One sync bit means one synchronization bit. So one, how many? 24 channel, and each channel consists of the 8 bit. So 24 multiplied by 8 plus 1 bit. So this is 192 plus 1 bit, that is 193 bits. So each frame consists of 193 bits, and each frame are responsible to transmit the 24 channels using the digital PCM, using the time division multiplex PCM or Tiber carrier system. So this is the time frame. There are 193 bits equals to one frame, or how many times? How to calculate the time period? Example, suppose we have FM is 4 kHz. FM is 4 kHz, basically this is the standard bandwidth of the speech signal or audio signal, the 4 kHz. So FS is greater than or equals to 2 type of FM, that is the 8 kHz. TS is 1 by FS or less than or equals to 1 by 8 kHz, that is 125 microsecond. This is the total time interval of the transmitting the one format. This time taken is 125 microsecond. Yeah? Now I am going to discuss the different parameter related to the TDM PCM signal. The first parameter is bit rate. How to calculate the bit rate? The bit rate is basically the number of bit per frame, that is number of bits per frame divided by the time of one frame. Yeah? How many bits? In one frame consists of the 193 bits, and to transmit the one frame, how much time is needed? 125 microsecond are needed. So this is equals to 193 bits divided by 125 microsecond. So it will come actually 1.544 megabit per second. Yeah, the bit rate of TDM PCM is number of bits per frame divided by the time taken to transmit the one frame. So this is the 1.544 megabit per second. So this is the bit rate. Here, signaling rate. How to calculate the signaling rate? Signaling rate is one upon the signaling period. So this is equals to 1 upon signaling period.
Signal, how to calculate the signaling period? How to calculate the signaling period?
Basically, now at a time it transmits only the 6 band.
So signaling period is basically this is equal to 1 upon
6 time. And if a signal 6 frame is transmitted, then it called the guard time. Guard time. So this is the 6 frame, and this frame time is 125. 6 into 125 microsecond. So this is 1 upon 750 microsecond. So this is the signaling rate.
Signaling rate. Right? And how to calculate the time duration of 1 bit? Time duration of 1 bit. This is equal to the time duration of 1 frame divided by the bit per frame. So this is equal to this formula used to calculate the time duration of 1 bit. What is the time duration to transmit the 1 bit through the DMPSM signal? So this is the time duration of 1 frame. Time duration of 1 frame is 125 microsecond and bit per frame. Clear? So this is equals to how much? 125 microsecond divided by bits per frame. Per frame how many bits? 193 bits. So this is the how to calculate the transmission bit bandwidth. Transmission bandwidth or channel bandwidth, this is equal to half of the bit rate. So this is 1 by 2, bit rate is how much? 1.544 megabit per second. So this is equal to 770 kilohertz. So this much bandwidth are required to transmit the T1 carrier signal. Channel bandwidth for the T1 carrier signal is the 770 kHz, and while the bit rate is the 1.544 megabit per second. Yeah? So these all are related to the TDM PCM signal. Yeah? Yeah? So today I discuss about the multiplexing. Multiplexing is a technique which converts multiple signals into the single output signal, or this is the many to one mapping, or this is used to unify the multiple signals. Yeah, so multiplexing are two types, analog multiplexing and digital multiplexing. Analog multiplexing are used for basically the TDM PAM signal, TDM PAM modulation scheme, while digital multiplexing techniques are used for the TDM PCM signal. Now, this TDM PCM techniques also known as T1 carrier system. Right? So today I discussed about the detail in the TDM PM system and TDM PCM system. And we have calculated the bit rate, signaling rate, and the time duration of the 1 bit transmission bandwidth of the T1 carrier system. Similarly, we have to calculate the bit rate of the TDM PM signal, transmission bandwidth of the TDM PCM signal, what is the signaling rate, what is the clear? These all are related to the multiplexing techniques used in the digital communication system. Thank you.